In this video, we're going to talk about two different types of risks that might arise from interest rate changes. So let's talk about the surplus of a firm. The way we calculate the surplus is that at a particular yield rate I, we do the difference between the assets and the liabilities, but we're worried about what the present values of those look like. So surplus for an interest rate I will be the present value of those assets at that same interest rate, minus the present value of the liabilities at that interest rate. So let's look at a particular example. Let's say a company has a $300 bill to pay in 10 years. They have two zero coupon bonds, one that matures for 160 in 2 years and one that matures for 168.77 in 30 years. Let's calculate the surplus of the company using this definition if the annual effective interest rate is 5%. Now again, you might be thinking a little bit about why do we have something maturing in 2 years and one maturing in 30 years to pay for a bill in 10? Well, if we have this one maturing in 2 years, we could reinvest the proceeds to help us grow to help pay off that bill, that $300 bill. Or the other one that's due in 30 years, we could use it and sell it at time 10 to help us pay the $300 bill. So we can use those in two different ways, which are going to help us illustrate the two different risks that are involved. So at 5% annual effective interest rate, the surplus is going to be take the 160, move it back 2 years. The 168.77, move it back 30 years. These two terms here give you the present value of the assets. Take the 300, move it back 10 years. That's your present value of your liabilities. Do that calculation, you get something close to zero. Now, if the yield rate decreases, the surplus is going to become negative. To see why, if it becomes negative, when you take this $160 bond, again, you're going to have to reinvest that to help pay the $300 bill in 10 years, if you were going to use that particular bond to do so. At a lower yield rate means it's not going to grow as much, which is going to mean it's going to be a little bit short when we start trying to help pay off this $300 bill. So this is what we call reinvestment risk, because again, we need to reinvest that $160 to help us pay off that liability in the future. So just as an example, if the interest rate dropped from 5 to 4, then the surplus, again, here's your present value of the assets at that 4% interest rate. Here is the present value of the liability. So our surplus would be negative $2.71. So we see that the interest rate dropped, the surplus dropped. Okay. So let's say we're going to try to mitigate some of this reinvestment risk. And to do that means that instead of investing 160 in the first bond, maybe we're going to invest a little bit less and move some of that over to the 30-year bond a little bit more. However, this now introduces a price risk, because remember, to help pay off this bill in 10 years, we would need to try to sell this bond at time 10. If the interest rate goes up, then the price will go down, and then again, we will not have as much money and as proceeds from that sale to help us pay off that liability. So going back to the original example, let's say instead we have purchased an $80 2-year zero coupon bond and a $482.38 30-year zero coupon bond. Again, at 5% annual effective, we get a zero surplus. However, now if the interest rate increases, the surplus becomes negative. So again, in this one, we've illustrated both types of risks that might occur when you have assets trying to meet liabilities. So what we're going to be looking for in future videos is try to figure out a way to protect ourselves from either lowering or increasing of interest rates, so that if we have our liabilities, we'll be able to meet our obligation as long as interest rates don't change significantly.